An iconic sports moment. Andy Murray becoming the first British man to win Wimbledon since 1936. While anyone can watch the replay of this video, only one superfan can claim the official rights to it after paying $177,000 at an auction for its authentic NFT.
A six-figure video could be just the beginning. NFT technology could have an impact well beyond collectibles and across industries. Applications are rapidly emerging, but the real implications of this tech for business could be huge. Maybe.
So let's dive into it. I'm Aaron.
And I'm Eliza.
And we're a part of Deloitte's Novel and Exponential Technologies team. And we're here to take you beyond the buzz of NFTs. To start with the basics, you've probably heard that NFT stands for non-fungible token. But to get a solid understanding of what that really means, let's break down the terms.
Sure. So first, fungibility. An item that is fungible can be replaced by an identical item of the same type. So $1 bill could be easily swapped for another dollar bill. That goes the same for commodities like pounds of flour, gallons of oil, or kilowatts of electricity. And historically, digital copies have been indistinguishable. So let's say our friend Mike sent us an adorable kitten picture from the internet. If I looked at the picture from my laptop and Aaron looked at it from his, well, neither one of those cat JPEGs are any more authentic or original than the other. In other words, they're fungible.
But they don't have to be. What if we gave Eliza's picture a certificate of authenticity and then stored it for everyone to see on a public ledger? Yeah, a blockchain. These certificates, or tokens, contain a unique ID. They become digital footprints that allow us to tell the difference between things that had previously looked the same in the digital world. And because of the tamper-proof nature of the blockchain, each non-fungible token is verifiably unique, is authentic, and has a trusted record of ownership.
Said another way, NFTs have introduced scarcity and ownership in a world of endless digital content. And this is why businesses are getting interested. Now, infinite supply had meant zero demand, whereas scarcity of digital supply, now that means profit.
And as the interest in NFTs increases, the market has ballooned. In 2021, it surpassed $40 billion, and venture capital poured in over $30 billion of investment into NFT-related startups.
If only I pitched an NFT startup in 2021.
Yeah, you and me both. Total NFT space investment in the last year resulted in 462% year-over-year growth, more than in every previous year combined.
Now, NFTs definitely exploded onto the scene in 2021, and if the last few years were about early adoption and hype, then the next few will test widespread application and commercial viability. No longer is it just about expensive digital artwork and profile pictures, but NFTs are opening new ways of doing business.
Exactly. And as companies continue to reduce friction points, NFTs will become more attractive and accessible to everyday folks, not just your techie friends and online communities.
But be careful, the NFT world is in its early days and pretty unregulated. Any business looking to get involved at this stage needs to be aware of potential reputational, regulatory, and financial risks.
But still, businesses have started to link digital tokens to real-world objects or experiences, creating an entirely new kind of product. Remember the six-figure Andy Murray NFT? Well, included with that purchase was a 30-minute game of tennis with Murray himself, along with court tickets to Wimbledon. A digital token is cool, but a digital token that's linked to real-world experiences, that's even cooler.
Way cooler. And the entertainment, gaming, and fashion industries are realizing this. Sports teams, rock bands, fashion designers, and other brands are issuing their own NFTs that could provide real-world benefits, from lifetime concert tickets to sports trading cards to even membership boat parties.
It's not just for entertainment, however. Nonprofits have also begun to auction NFTs for fundraising campaigns and for scholarships.
Exactly. So already, NFTs are being used to drive brand engagement, consumer experiences, and philanthropy. But the technology behind them opens doors for new ways of working as well. So, Aaron, how about we start with next-gen digital twins?
Okay, so a digital twin is a virtual representation of a physical object or system, like a diamond or a machine. By using NFTs as that virtual representation, you can bring the benefits of the blockchain, like security, transparency, and traceability, to the entire life of the product.
And this NFT digital twinning could be helpful for companies with insecure supply chains or for products that need maintenance or updates after being sold. And this is already happening. A luxury car maker announced it will start attaching NFTs to its SUVs to log vehicle data, helping owners document service history and other information that's really important during resale.
And digital twinning with NFTs also opens the door to fractionalized ownership. An NFT digital twin can be split apart or fractionalized, helping to divide real-world assets into smaller parts owned by lots of people, just like shares of a company. With NFTs, you and a group of strangers could split the cost and ownership rights of something really expensive, like a private jet, a yacht, or even a Chicago high-rise.
And this allows for democratized investing, greater liquidity, and increased rental market opportunities, and offers the chance to finally own that super yacht. And the terms of agreement between you and the other yacht owners, that would be defined in the NFT smart contract, like whether you could only use the yacht twice a year, visit Saint-Tropez, or how you'd pay those maintenance fees. That's within the smart contract.
Exactly, which reminds me, we do need to talk about smart contracts. They are the code that lock in the terms of agreement and are executed automatically at an NFT's initial point of sale and every sale after that. So if a smart contract says that the original creator of the NFT gets a royalty for each additional resale, that's exactly what happens.
We could be looking at a never-before-seen way of doing business where creators, from musicians to manufacturers, can realize more enduring profits from their creations.
But remember, we're actually all creators of our own personal data. Imagine an NFT linked to a digital file that contains your information, your internet traffic, your biometrics, so forth. A personal data vault, if you will, that you own and you can monetize as you'd like. New startups are already forming NFT personal data marketplaces, especially for medical data.
These and other innovative business cases will evolve as the underlying technology becomes more mature. So, next time you hear NFTs, hopefully you'll be able to look beyond someone's tokenized profile pictures and cut through the buzz.
And hey, if you're the proud owner of that Andy Murray NFT, we're more than happy to join you at Wimbledon. Thanks, and we'll see you next time on
Beyond the Buzz.